the caution that I often speak about and is in some of the prognostic research is, you know, don't give a temporal prognosis. Like if I say I think you've got a month to live, or if I say you've got 6 months to live, then the patient and the family probably are going to lock on to that. You said 6 months, and you've quoted that, you've heard that yourself, and I've certainly heard it lots of times. Sometimes the surgeon has said, oh, you're doing well, you got a year to live, you know, at least a year. Now, how they came up with that, you know, maybe suspect. But what the person heard is a specific time, and it often gets locked in. And they're fully expecting, in some ways, to die by 6 months. Now, if they die in 6 weeks, that's pretty hard because they thought they had longer. Now, if they live longer, you might think, well, that's a really good thing. and in many ways, it probably is, of course. But there can be an anger, a lingering lack of trust, a number of things that happen. You told me I had 6 months, and you know, here I am 2 years later, so you know, I don't go to that doctor anymore, right? So to the extent that we can get better at a prognosis, the better it will be to serve everyone, and that's where giving a specific time is always wrong. So what we talk about is probabilistic time. So you might say that the average person, you know, with your disease, the average time might be 6 months, but that's an average. Some people will die sooner than that. Some people will live longer than that. And I don't know for sure where you fit. We can talk about it a little more. And when I see you again in a couple of weeks or whatever, we'll see how you're doing, because things may have changed and we can talk about it again. So if you begin to make it the true reality is that there's a range of things there, most people can understand and will appreciate that then. You didn't lock yourself into a certain amount of time for which you would be wrong.